The biggest Sushant news break yet is the disclosure made by Sushant Singh Rajput's neighbor. Yes, viewers, for the first time in this two-month-old saga, the neighbor of Sushant Singh Rajput has come out and broken a silence on Times Now. She has said that there was something somewhere suspicious, something amiss. Listen in to what she said.
की लाइट जो है 10:30 सब बंद कर दी गई थी
जी जी।
सिर्फ एक किचन की लाइट ऑन थी और कभी भी हमेशा कभी ऐसे उसकी लाइट कभी ऑफ होती नहीं थी। 7:00 तक जागता था। बट उस दिन जो आप लोग बोल रहे पार्टी थी, कोई पार्टी नहीं हुई, कुछ नहीं हुआ।
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कहीं कुछ लाइट, क्योंकि जनरली ऐसे आप कह रहे हैं नहीं,
जनरली लाइट ऑफ नहीं होती है, सो दिस वाज कंप्लीटली ऑफ।
तो मतलब कहीं
समथिंग समवेयर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इट।
ओके मैम,
की लाइट जो है 10:30 सब बंद कर दी गई थी
जी जी।
सिर्फ एक किचन की लाइट ऑन थी और कभी भी हमेशा कभी ऐसे उसकी लाइट कभी ऑफ होती नहीं थी। 7:00 तक जागता था। बट उस दिन जो आप लोग बोल रहे पार्टी थी, कोई पार्टी नहीं हुई, कुछ नहीं हुआ।
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कहीं कुछ लाइट, क्योंकि जनरली ऐसे आप कह रहे हैं नहीं,
जनरली लाइट ऑफ नहीं होती है, सो दिस वाज कंप्लीटली ऑफ।
तो मतलब कहीं
समथिंग समवेयर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इट।
ओके मैम,
लाइट जो है 10:30 सब बंद कर दी गई थी
जी जी।
सिर्फ एक किचन की लाइट ऑन थी और कभी भी हमेशा कभी ऐसे उसकी लाइट कभी ऑफ होती नहीं थी। 7:00 तक जागता था। बट उस दिन जो आप लोग बोल रहे पार्टी थी, कोई पार्टी नहीं हुई, कुछ नहीं हुआ।
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कहीं कुछ लाइट, क्योंकि जनरली ऐसे आप कह रहे हैं नहीं,
जनरली लाइट ऑफ नहीं होती है, सो दिस वाज कंप्लीटली ऑफ।
तो मतलब कहीं
समथिंग समवेयर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इट।
ओके मैम,
की लाइट जो है 10:30 सब बंद कर दी गई थी
जी जी।
सिर्फ एक किचन की लाइट ऑन थी और कभी भी हमेशा कभी ऐसे उसकी लाइट कभी ऑफ होती नहीं थी। 7:00 तक जागता था। बट उस दिन जो आप लोग बोल रहे पार्टी थी, कोई पार्टी नहीं हुई, कुछ नहीं हुआ।
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कहीं कुछ लाइट, क्योंकि जनरली ऐसे आप कह रहे हैं नहीं,
जनरली लाइट ऑफ नहीं होती है, सो दिस वाज कंप्लीटली ऑफ।
तो मतलब कहीं
समथिंग समवेयर, आई डोंट नो व्हाट इट।
ओके मैम,
there's something somewhere, says Sushant Singh Rajput's neighbor. She has come out for the first time to spill the beans, if I can use that word. The lights were switched off early. What happened that day? Siddhant, Kajal Iyer joining us. Yes, Siddhant.
Well, that's right, Pranesh. This is the first time that any neighbor has spoken out, and she has completely denied any party taking place at Sushant's residence. Before the day he died first, second, it has also raised suspicion on the fact that there were no lights on inside his apartment. So this is what neighbors are telling us. And the fact here is, Pranesh, that even the CBI is going to question the neighbors of Sushant Singh Rajput, and their statements will also be recorded, because as far as the movement inside his flat or inside his premises is concerned, it's only neighbors who can confirm. Now the fact is that that this neighbor has come out today and spoken to media, is standing out, and she has very clearly said that there was no party, but there were no lights on. Now why the lights were switched off, this is a big question, and it is raising suspicion that why there were no lights on inside Sushant's flat. You know, Pranesh, several of the testimonies that we have got, even people have confirmed that that many used to believe that the house was haunted. We have those testimonies also where people are saying that it was a general belief among the staff and other
right.
people also that the house was haunted. And perhaps this was a reason that some puja and black magic also took place allegedly. This is what the staff
and
has confirmed
was,
to
was
us.
Was this neighbor questioned by the Mumbai police, Kajal Iyer? I don't think Kajal can hear me, but let me open this up. Shehzad Poonawala joins our broadcast. Syed Asad Abbas also with us. Good evening to you, Shehzad and Mr. Abbas. Shehzad, let me begin with you. What do you make of this disclosure by Sushant's neighbor?
The words used by the neighbor has revealed a lot. And, you know, ordinarily, Sushant's lights were not switched on so early. This means, now compare this with the fact that post-mortem does not mention time of death. Can it be possible that the death occurred in the intervening night of 13th and 14th? And if it was a death that occurred at that time, then the suicide theory now, after so many questions anyways on the post-mortem report, etc., has gone out of the window. So now we come to the question of murder. And in the question of murder, who are the people in the house? There were four people in the house. The cook, Mr. Pithani, Mr. Dipesh, and one more person, Ashok, I believe. So these four people need to be questioned. We are being questioned. The scene recreation is happening right now. A dummy test will also happen to rule out everything else. But the question is also that on the day of the death, that is 14th, which we think it is the day of the death, there is Sandeep Singh, another shady character who enters the scene to clear up the entire crime scene because unauthorized access to the crime scene is given, unauthorized access to the mortuary is given.
And the security guard Shehzad is also being questioned as we speak. I'll come back to you. Another guest joining us, Dr. Kuldeep Datta, is a renowned cardiologist, internal medicine expert. Dr. Datta, thank you for speaking to us here on Times Now. Very good evening to you. What do you make of all of this?
The time has to be precisely, you know, given in an approximation. And when you say that the rigor mortis is present in the lower limbs, that puts the time at about 12 hours, plus minus 5 hours. So if the postmortem is done at 11:30, so the time of death is 11 o'clock in the morning, plus minus 5 hours, this way or that way. So that's the time that he died. And did the doctors take a rectal temperature to see the body's core temperature? Because in 12 hours, the body will come down to a core temperature of 25 degrees. It loses 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit per hour. So taking the core temperature was very important to find the time of death. So was it taken or not taken?
And that's an important question. Why was the post-mortem autopsy done after sunset? And where is the order of the magistrate? Because usually the post-mortem is done after sunset only during war, natural calamity, or where there's a problem of law and order, Dr. Datta?
Yes, absolutely. That's what Modi says. Textbook of jurisprudence, that's what it says. So the magistrate has to give in writing why he wants the post-mortem after sunset.
And who were the people who constituted a team of five doctors and what are the reasons for doing so? That is another question that hasn't been answered so far. And when the CBI team asked the team of doctors who asked them to do the post-mortem, they said we were under instruction from the Mumbai police. Shehzad, I'll bring you in.
No, the Bombay police cannot instruct them. It has to be the magistrate.
Right, Shehzad.
I want to ask doctor one question. Is it possible that the death, and I'm not calling it a suicide, the mysterious death could have taken place at around 10:30, 11 or somewhere around that time on 13th night. If that is a possibility, the lights going off unusually and the death happening at around that time or possibly happening at that time, that itself raises a lot of questions that was not a suicide. It convincingly proves that it is not a suicide. Doctor, could the death have happened at around that time on 13th night?
You see, 11:30, if you do the postmortem, it comes at 11 o'clock in the morning and plus minus 5 or 6 hours. That's it.
So there you go. That means the death has happened when the lights were switched off.
Absolutely. There's something amiss. There is something amiss. The neighbor has said that lights were switched off early around 10:30, 10:45. And she also then in the same breath said that Sushant used to be up till about 4 a.m. So we have a problem, Mr. Abbas.
Well, Pranay Sahab,
I was listening to Dr. Datta very carefully.
I think this is not just a matter of Sushant alone, but it is somebody who's been looked upon as a superstar, not just in India, but all over the world. Now that the Central Bureau of Investigation has come in, there is a meticulous way which CBI functions in accordance with their respective teams, with its planning and strategy. I think the cards are going to fall off one by one. This is all going to be a catastrophe of sorts, which will be put to rest. I think we should also look at the matter as to where is this investigation going and where will it lead up to? Because there has been many conspiracy theories. Time and again, we've been coming across. There's also been a trial by media of sorts. There have been
one minute, Mr. Abbas. I object to that. What is this trial by media? Could you elaborate, Mr. Syed Asad Abbas? The Mumbai police has failed. The Mumbai police botched up the probe. There was an attempt to cover up. There are several things that the media has highlighted. Times Now investigation has brought out so many facts in the case. And you are calling this trial by media. Could you elaborate, sir?
Certainly, sir. Trial by media, I ask so, is because What is the qualification of the media to act as Sherlock Holmes or police officials?
Is this the first case? No, no, 1 minute. Isn't it the job of the media to bring out facts and truth? 1 minute. No, no. What qualification? What qualification should one need to bring out the facts? Tell me.
Sir, the Central Bureau of Investigation has experience.
Are they know Mr. Abbas, the CBI has only taken over the case 2 days ago. Mumbai police wasted so much of time. 2 months. How can you call this trial by media? Shehzad, is this trial by media?
Allow me 30 seconds. So basically, what do we see, sir? The Central Bureau of Investigation...
No, these same shameless people, they were using media reports on Loya's death to say that Loya has been murdered. These same people were saying that the media has proven that Loya was murdered. And when Loya's family was not demanding a court, the Supreme Court had looked into the matter that wanted a media trial there. Today they are calling this a media trial. Because family is saying they are doubting the role of Mumbai police.
Is not going to help this case. I think let's stand by the WhatsApp
viewers
and let's have full faith that Sushant is served justice.
Mr. Abbas, are you done? Can I make a point? Thank you. Mr. Abbas, your entire...
Mr. Abbas, I'll come back to you, Shehzad.
Sure.
This entire gang used to use media reports, Judge Loya's death, and call it a murder. That time they were Sherlock.
Mr. Abbas, do you remember our coverage on the Tuticorin incident when two people were tortured to death by the police? Did you call it media trial then? Do you remember our coverage on Sengar, the BJP MLA who was expelled? Did you call it media trial then?
Tuticorin,
do you remember the Arushi case? Was it media trial? Media brought out several inconsistencies. Come on, Mr. Abbas. Come on. I want to go back to Dr. Datta. Dr. Datta.
I do.
You know, one question that I want to ask you. Why was the Mumbai police in such a hurry to hand over the flat back to the flat owner? Because in the Sunanda Pushkar case, the Delhi police paid the rent of that room in which Sunanda Pushkar was found dead for good 2 years, because you see the investigations were going on.
I don't think I'm competent to answer that question. I can answer your question on the jurisprudence and on the autopsy.
And talking about the autopsy, Dr. Datta, there is no timestamp.
No, time has to be written and time can be derived in cross-questioning. Once the doctor says it is rigor mortis is present in the lower limbs, so it makes it 12 hours. It makes it exactly 12 hours. And he has not taken the core temperature, so he can't tell you what was the core temperature of the body. The body loses 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit per hour. And if the normal body temperature is 98.6, you calculate minus the core temperature, you minus it from 98.6, you minus the core temperature and you get the number of hours if you divide by 1.5.
And not just that, there are several other inconsistencies that we've highlighted. Shehzad, I'll come back to that. I am under pressure to take a short break. We return in just a bit. Welcome back. This is the biggest coverage of the Sushant investigation on Times Now. The murder mystery is deepening. Shehzad Poonawalla, Syed Asad Abbas with us. Shehzad, the neighbors' testimony has now only added to the suspense, and the Mumbai police botch up stands exposed.
The Mumbai police must have not even asked this neighbor for her version, because had she said her version to Mumbai police, they would have started investigating, they would have found out a time of death, and they would have put it in the postmortem. That postmortem is the biggest cover-up job or a hatchet job that I've ever seen in my life. The crime scene was allowed to be desecrated with shady characters like Sandeep Singh walking in and giving thumbs up after basically ensuring that everything has been covered up. Then he's handling the entire funeral proceedings. Riya is going to the mortuary without any access. Riya is not questioned, and suddenly these people are now defending a certain big Bollywood lobby. And Sandeep Singh, who was not in the picture at all, who sent on 14, gets a call from Dubai. I mean,
What else do you need to understand that this is a very big cover-up job, and therefore Mumbai police knows that the real links are with some big political mafia, Bollywood Agadi nexus. Therefore, to hide this, they were obstructing the CBI. And my final question, if Mumbai police was doing such a fantastic job, no FIR, now when the CBI is going and doing the investigations, they are going to the house of Sushant over and over again. Why are they going? Who's called them there? Why are they trying to still desecrate the crime scene when the CBI is trying to recreate the crime scene?
Mr. Abbas,
being done on a very critical
before you answer that, I also want to tell our viewers that when Sushant's family demanded justice, the family was discredited, they were slandered. And now that this neighbor has come out to say what she observed, attempts are being made to discredit and malign her also. Mr. Abbas.
I think let be a neighbor who is willing to be an eyewitness and of course will be spoken to the Central Bureau of Investigation must not
but
be
Mr. Abbas, she can
whatsoever.
Only be an eyewitness
also,
no 1 minute, why now, why didn't the Mumbai police make her a witness? Answer that question. Why didn't the isn't it now you tell me sir isn't it fundamental that you speak to the neighbors?
If I'm allowed to make my point,
please.
Sir. Thank you. So, time and again, Pranay Sahab, we see Mumbai police being discredited and defamed every single day. But I think we also need to understand that the Mumbai police is not just one of the best in India, but also considered by a long yardstick and compared to the Scotland Yard. To
Mr. Abbas, how does that matter? Give them the medal, give
ahead.
Them the certificate,
let's,
give them what you have, what you want to. But give justice to Sushant's family. Give them closure.
Certainly. On this point,
it's been 2 months. This has become a joke.
Sushant's family must not be discredited whatsoever. They've lost a son and justice must
they
be
were.
Met.
They were discredited. The damage has been done. No, damage has been done. And you know the people who did that. You know those individuals.
No, sir,
you have to condemn them.
The damage has not been done, sir. The CBI has come in. We have full faith in CBI. Let CBI take its course. And I'm sure the truth will come out, sir. Satyamev Jayate. And it should. Also, as a matter of fact, Siddharth Pitani, Sandeep Singh, my good friend, Shehzad also
all
mentioned
this,
about...
All this won't change the facts in the case, Mr. Abbas. Shehzad Poonawala, Mr. Abbas, thank you for speaking to us. We're completely out of time. But before I end the show, let's once again listen to Sushant's neighbor. Look what she says.
लाइट जो है 10:30-11 बजे सब बंद कर दी गई थी
जी जी।
सिर्फ एक किचन की लाइट ऑन थी और कभी भी हमेशा कभी ऐसे उसकी लाइट कभी ऑफ होती नहीं थी 7:00 बजे तक जागता था बट उस दिन जो आप लोग बोल रहे पार्टी थी कोई पार्टी नहीं हुई कुछ नहीं हुआ
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कहीं कुछ लाइट क्योंकि जनरली ऐसे आप कह रहे हैं नहीं
जनरली लाइट ऑफ नहीं होती है सो दिस वाज कंप्लीटली ऑफ
तो मतलब कहीं
समथिंग समवेयर आई डोंट नो व्हाट
ओके मैम